Okay, welcome to the test.
Yes.
We're going to begin now with questions on plant and animal cells. So can you tell me, what's the difference between an animal cell and a plant cell? One and more laughing, come on.
The plant
cell has a cell wall, yes?
Yes.
And a chloroplast.
Yes.
Very good. I know you know that, you're just laughing a lot, okay? Alright, what does the nucleus do?
The nucleus contains majority in the cell genetic in the form of
the form of the
DNA.
Excellent. What is the vacuole?
It's food, water and collects waste.
Good. Alright. So how can we see cells? What do we use?
By microscope.
Very good. What is the mitochondria?
The mitochondria release the energy from food.
Good. What is the function of the chloroplast?
The chloroplast.
What happens there? Very good. Very good. Okay, so some questions on plants. So what is a vascular plant?
Is the plant have a tooth running up and down?
Very good. Can you give me an example?
Apple trees, flowers.
Very good. Okay, so what do roots do?
The roots suck up the water inside and uncle up in the
sun. Very good. What do leaves do?
Leaves do the photosynthesis. Use the carbon dioxide and water to make sugar.
Very good. What is fungus?
It's the initial cell of the organism.
Can you give me an example of a fungus?
Mushroom and yeast.
Good. What's a penicillin?
The penicillin is the antibiotic that kills the harmful bacteria.
Excellent. And where does it come from? Where do we get penicillin from?
In mushroom.
Or the
penicillin mushroom.
Fungus, right?
Yes.
Good. Alright, so let's have a look at the next one. What is an angiosperm?
It's a seed plant that produces flowers.
Very good. Do ferns have seeds or spores?
Ferns have spores.
Very good. Can you name two ways in which seeds can be scattered?
By wind and animals.
Very good. Alright, so let's have a look at the next one. About animals. What is a vertebrate?
Animals have backbone.
Can you give an example of an invertebrate?
Is the squid and the snail.
Very good. How do fish take oxygen from water?
By gills.
Good. Can you give an example of an amphibian?
Frog.
Frog, very good. Can you name two types of reptiles?
Is a lizard and snake.
Very good. So body systems, can you name two organ systems?
The nervous system and digestive system.
What is digestion?
The digestion is how the food turn the food into the energy.
Okay, so after you eat the food, is it then you digest it, is that correct? So after you eat the food, what happens? Where does the food go? It goes down your...
The esophagus.
Very good, and it goes where?
In the stomach.
Into your stomach. What happens then?
The stomach will digest the food, and then the food will go into the body cell.
Good. Alright, and how is it brought there? What transfers Would it be your nervous system or your circulatory system?
I think it's circulatory system.
So what is the circulatory system?
The circulatory system is the transport of the
blood. It's the blood, right?
Yes.
Very good. So how does the blood move around the body? What pushes it?
The heart.
Very good. All right. So going back to the digestive system, what do the large intestines do?
It push the waste out of the body.
Very good. And what is the function of the diaphragm?
It helps the lungs to when it inhale.